My name is Chris. I'm a senior from Westside. And this is my poem, 43-365. Day 43, Valentine's Day. It was never my thing. I never liked the idea of doing mostly one-on-one things with a partner. I always looked at it as an excuse to tell my friends that I love them. While I'm at school here in Nebraska, sitting in the classroom, staring at walls to get out of schoolwork, all I can think is, man, I want to die. School is boring me to death. Little did I know, they took me before to high school, hiding behind desks, in corners and closets, their eyes shut, tears of fear screaming down my cheeks, thinking, I don't want to die 43 days into 2018. 47 different mass shootings, 18 different schools, filled with the sound of gunshots instead of school bells. Screaming instead of laughter, police sirens wailing instead of a choir singing, filled with the sound of silence. Silence as a 16-year-old hits the ground. Silence as they're told not to talk while being rushed out of the school. Silence as everybody talks about it, as they send their thoughts and prayers, as the victim's family weeps, yet all we get is silence. Silence from elected officials, just silence. Do not tell me this only affects the victims, because I know what I saw when three of my teachers broke down crying. Crying because they couldn't imagine one of us not coming back to class. Crying because they had kids of their own. Crying because they remember something like this happening when they were in high school. It was Valentine's Day. While kids were supposed to give strangers, they only saw in hallways, heart cuts and construction paper, they were holding on to each other in fear. While they were supposed to give their English teacher chocolate in a heart-shaped box, they were pressing their own shirts into her stomach to stop the bleeding. This isn't supposed to happen. I'm not supposed to wonder what I would do in a situation like that. None of us should be worried about going to school one morning and never coming back home. None of us should worry about why someone is reaching into their backpack. Is it a gun or a water bottle, a weapon, or a notebook? You're more afraid of losing your guns than you are losing your kids. You treat both weapons like your children more than you treat those your own children like your children. Everybody always talks about how sad it is, how it has to stop, how he was a broken child. Nobody ever talks about how he bought the gun legally, how easy it was for him to change the gun's magazine to kill more people, or how 73% of gun crimes were committed legally purchased weapons. So, no, do not tell me gun violence does not exist. Do not tell me there's no way to prevent it. Do not tell me you won't let this happen again. There's a way to stop it before it even happens. And I'm not talking about million-dollar alarm systems or tear gas. Only America would turn places of education into prisons rather than getting rid of the weapons. So now it's day 85. 68 mass shootings, 22 of them being in schools. We only have 280 days of this year left. And everyone is just waiting for the next headline, worst mass shooting in United States history. Every single one always seems to be the worst. But I guess we'll just wait. Because that's just easier, right?